Hey everybody, welcome to the SaaS YouTube channel. My name is Jennifer Waller and I'm going to be talking today about how do you restructure your data using arrays and do loops. Inevitably, I get data at Augusta University where I work that is what I call short and wide data. So it's one observation per subject, but there are multiple time points, there are multiple variables within that row, and that is not how I need the data so that I can analyze it. I do a lot of mixed model analysis and not a lot of MANOVA, and so when I'm analyzing data, I like to have what I call a long and skinny data set. So instead of this short, wide data set, I like to have a long, skinny data set. And so let me show you what I mean by that. So this is what I call a short and wide data set. And so since we're in the middle of this COVID-19 pandemic, I thought it would be neat to just go out and grab the data that I knew of for Georgia. And so I went to a reporting site that is tracking this and just pulled off the data. And I, like an idiot, because I wasn't thinking, I entered all of the data in one observation. So every day there's a number of positive cases, a number of negative cases, the number that were hospitalized, and then the number of deaths. And this is starting literally yesterday, and then going back to March, I believe it's March 4th, 2020. So this is what I call a short, wide data set. It's short because it's one observation per person. It is wide because how many variables do I have here? Probably like 160 some odd variables. So that's what I consider a short, wide data set. So I now need to actually make this into a long, skinny data set. And so how do I do that? Well, I'm going to show you how to do that by setting up arrays and then by utilizing do loops on those arrays. So let's get into it. Let me get my SAS up here. So this is the COVID-19 data. I just pulled it in here. Okay, and the first step that you want to do is actually set up an array for each of the variables in your data set that you want to create just one new variable, just one from that string of many across the time points. Okay, so there are 33 days in this data set, but I want the positives, all of the positives, those 33 positive values to go into one variable. So right now they're long and there's 33 variables. I want to collapse those into one variable called positives that has 33 rows to it. Okay, or for each day, I want a row of data. And so I am going to create an array for the positives. I'm going to create an array for the negatives here. I'm going to create an array for the hospitalizations, and I'm going to create an array for the deaths. And so for all of this, you'll notice that I actually have 33 array elements. Now, in my previous talk that I did for SAS Global Forum 2020, I indicated that index there in curly brackets is the number of variables in the array. So that's all I'm doing is looking at 33 variables in each array. All right, so the next thing that we have to do, so I've set up my arrays. Great! Now I actually have to use them. How do I do that? Well, the way I do that is by starting with a do loop. And you start that do loop here with the do. I'm using an iterative do loop because I literally want to reference each variable in the array. So do I equals the first variable in the array to 33. And you will notice that 33 matches those 33s here in each of those array statements. So that's key. So I'm going to iterate over those arrays, and I'm going to iterate one at a time, going from 1 to 33. Okay, I then create a time point variable. So my reporting day, I use the MDY function. I start on the first day that we started reporting, March 3rd, 2020. We actually started March 4th, 2020. And then I take that index that I'm using to go over my data set, and I subtract off, essentially I subtract 33 minus I to get the correct date. The next step is to really then take that, and now we're going to create our variables. Okay, so our created variables, I'm going to have the number of positives for each day. I'm going to have the number of negatives for each day. I'm going to have the number of hospitalizations for each day. And then I'm going to have the number of deaths. But I also can create new variables. So I'm going to create the total number of cases based on the number of positives plus the number of negatives. I'm going to create the death rate for each day, which is essentially the number of deaths out of the number of positive cases for that day. That's the best I can do in terms of calculating that death rate based on the data that I have. So I jump right in. So I'm creating a new variable called positives, and I'm setting the value in the positive array, a pos, for the ith element of the array to that new variable positives. I do the same thing for negatives. I do the same thing for hospitalizations. I do the same thing for deaths. And then I'm calculating. What's nice is I can then calculate my new variables based on these new variables, so I don't have to reference that array element. I could if I wanted to, but I don't need to. So my total number of cases is just the sum of my positives and negatives, and then my death rate is my number of deaths over my number of positives. You could multiply that by 100 if you wanted it to be a percentage, whatever you want to. The next key statement in outputting each iteration of this do loop to a new observation is this output statement. That is key. If you miss that output statement, it's not going to create a new row for each iteration of the array. It's just going to tack on to the end of that one observation. So that output statement is key. And then I end the do loop like you should. I drop the variables that I don't need, which is what I have here, dropping these variables that I don't need, and I'm done. And what happens when I actually run this code? Well, what happens is this. I get one observation per day, and I get those number of positives, I get the number of negatives, I get the hospitalizations, I get the number of deaths. I calculated that total number of cases, and if you want to check that the computer is doing that, well, guess what? 6,647 plus 21,185 actually does equal 27,832. And so that's where we're at in Georgia right now. We're not doing so hot. I don't know why, but we really need to get on this thing. And then I calculate the death rate. So that, in a nutshell, is how to restructure your data. I do want to point you to some resources for more information. You can always check out the SAS documentation. You can check out my SAS Global Forum 2020 paper. It's titled A Beginner's Guide to Using Arrays and Do Loops. I also have a video of that on this SAS User's YouTube channel. If you have any questions at all, I would be more than happy to answer them. Just post your questions in the comments section and I will check back. And please do subscribe to the SAS YouTube SAS users YouTube channel, there is a lot of great, great, great information on how to learn how to do stuff with SAS. I want to thank you for joining me today and have just a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks.